What's up, Frame Fam? Welcome back to another video. If you've been following my channel for a while now, you've probably heard me talk about the Navi 22 GPU, aka the possible RX 6800 or 6700 series in previous videos. One thing I could never pinpoint in those videos based off of insider rumors and leaks were specifications, which led us to speculate based off of currently known RDNA 2 codename tiers in retrospect to AMD's RDNA 1 GPU codenames. And as a result of this speculation, along with insider rumors, we know that AMD will release three main GPU lines: Navi 21, which will target the top tier performance sector and compete with Nvidia's RTX 3080 and other GPUs that may release in that performance ballpark, while Navi 22 will compete with Nvidia's rumored RTX 3060 Ti and soon to release RTX 3070, and finally Navi 23, which will squeeze into the entry level performance tiers, likely to compete with any future 3050 or equivalent GPUs from Nvidia. Although many folks could guess all of that just based off of what makes sense and what Nvidia and AMD typically do with each new generation. That being said, everything I am about to say to you, take with a huge grain of salt. As I always say, nothing is true until it is, but due to recent leaks from a Linux kernel update made aware to us by Reddit user Stubbler, we may know a little bit more about Navi 22's hardware specs that will help us paint a performance picture of AMD's mid-tier RDNA 2 GPUs. In this firmware update, we can see two RDNA 2 codenames. We already know Sienna Chichlid is the Navi 21 line of GPUs, and Navy Flounder are the Navi 22 and Navi 23 line. But now we have extra recent specs written in front of us in black and white due to this update to accompany the rumors so far, and it looks like the future Navi 22, RX 68 and or 6700 XT will have 40 CUs, providing a total of 2560 stream processors, and is said to have 12 gigabytes of GDDR6 VRAM that may run on a 192-bit memory bus. If true, this would grant AMD's next-gen mid-tier GPUs to have the same exact amount of CUs and stream processors as the current flagship RX 5700 XT, while also benefiting from RDNA 2 50% increase in performance per watt efficiency, on top of 4 extra gigabytes of video memory. Now, I'm not saying for sure that the future RDNA 2 midline GPUs are guaranteed to be at least 50% faster than the current RDNA 1 RX 5700 XT. I mean, on paper it sure seems that way, but it's not exactly clear how much faster a future RX 6800 or 6700 would be, taking a step back from the 256-bit memory bus the 5700 XT has down to the 192-bit size. Without benchmarks, it's all just an educated guess at this point, but some people have told me that the performance boost from RDNA 1 to RDNA 2 with an extra 4 GB of VRAM will certainly make up for the memory bandwidth differential. Now, Navi 22 GPUs may not be 50% faster than the RX 5700 XT like it seems at first glance, but it's definitely possible it'll be close enough to be considered very impressive for its price point, especially with Big Navi being rumored to cost as little as $450 to $400. We can only assume that this mid-tier GPU would be in the $300 price mark range, but I want to know what you guys all think about this. Do you think AMD has some heat tucked away, ready to bring fierce competition to the market that'll impress us all, or do you think things won't be as good for AMD this year? Let me know down in the comments, and I'll be sure to engage with you all, and I look forward to hearing your thoughts. Anyway, fam, that's all I have for you today. As always, it's been my pleasure. Please stay safe, stay happy, and keep on gaming.